You know the type of guy I'm talking about. The guy who is too eager to show off his tailored Italian suits, scintillating jewelry and precious metals, all the while maintaining a smug smirk on his face. Just by looking at him, you can pick up his heavy aroma of privilege, if it weren't covered up by the expensive cologne that he dabs on heavily. They are the men at the very top of the societal echelon, usually benefiting from a legacy of wealth and privilege. Another thing that they have in common? Everybody loves to see these upper-class men get their arrogant asses kicked. Because these guys fly so high, when they crash, it's simply more spectacular and satisfying to watch. American society is trained to believe that men who spend too much time fussing about their appearance are either overcompensating or potentially homosexual. And these entrenched beliefs means that the crowd is just hungry for these vain men to be destroyed. In this video, I will identify 5 ways to know for sure that you're watching one of these cocky, rich wrestlers. Number 1. Obsession with perfect physical appearance. The word understated is not in the cocky, rich wrestler's vocabulary. Allergic to generic fashions, he would never be seen wrestling in a wife beater or a pair of jeans, as he is preoccupied with displaying his body in luxury fashion labels and wrestling in exquisite designs, eye-catching colors, and an expensive sheen. A great example of this is David Otunga. This narcissist's love for himself is almost immoral, as he loves labels and enjoys a mirror more than anything else. Even when he was being beaten up backstage, he yells out to his attacker to spare his Versace trunks.
Come on.
Hey man, these are Versace
back
shorts.
It up. Back it up.
Back it up.
Back it up.
Come on.
Number 2. Preening peacock promos. If you can't spot a cocky rich wrestler by his looks, then you will surely be able to identify him by his words. He can't get enough of talking about himself, and he gets off on his sense of superiority by admonishing the unwashed masses for their lack of education, money, and class.
The popcorn grease seeping out of your pores. I can literally hear you getting fatter.
The unwashed masses plunge further into the bowels of your own inadequacies and shortcomings.
This makes the crowd rabid with anger, which seems to only feed his own ego. And when they are not bragging about stealing your girl, these privileged boys can be found complaining about unfair odds, bitching and whining about supposed injustices. Number 3. Out of touch. When you live in an elite bubble, it's no surprise that you're not exactly in touch with the realities and standards of the rest of the population. These cocky, rich, pretty boys have their heads so far up their asses that they've gotten used to the smell of their own shit, and it takes a rude awakening to knock some sense into them. A great example of this was when Ted DiBiase Jr. rudely interrupted the bona fide legend Triple H, who was in the midst of making a challenge to The Undertaker. Ted walked up confidently and foolishly, demanding like a spoiled child that he hasn't been given enough attention.
The people will have no choice but to take notice of me, Ted DiBiase.
Either way, let's just say the superior Triple H utterly humiliated this rich kid, leaving him ass side up with thousands of people pointing and laughing at it. Rich boy Ted DiBiase continued to show his obliviousness in his feud with R-Truth. To show you how out of touch Ted is, he decided to regale the crowd with some Frank Sinatra, which might have been more successful with the Sunday church ladies than with the WWE crowd. While geared up to fight in purple trunks, Ted DiBiase also tried to connect with the masses with a more contemporary dance. And to his credit, he was 100% committed, and with a bit more training, he could have earned a role in the Magic Mike movie instead of boos from the crowd. Number 4. Using power and influence to bend the rules. One of the perks of being rich is that you can pay someone else to do the work for you and manipulate situations in your favor instead of having to lift a muscle. The cocky rich wrestler rarely travels alone, and he employs loyal accomplices to do his dirty work. Look at Alberto Del Rio, for example. with his hired personal ring announcer adding to the pouncing of CM Punk, a commoner, when he refuses to change a match for the Mexican aristocrat. And finally, number 5, the crowd just goes wild watching their asses get beaten. In American society, there is still a strong underlying cultural value that believes men should not obsess over their beauty and peacock around in extravagant fashions, which are traits associated with homosexuality. I think it comes very naturally for Americans to desire the punishment and humiliation of vain men, to straighten them out in a way that they think is deserved. As much as we hate to admit it, the cocky rich wrestler is, objectively speaking, superior to the average person because of their high net worths and education. Therefore, we desire to see these rich men punished for their lack of humility, twisted into pretzels and embarrassed. When a wrestler knows how to manipulate his arrogance to drive an audience to madness, he can become one of the most effective characters in the wrestling arena. You subconsciously admire him, but you freaking hate him too, and most importantly, you just can't look away. And that is why I think MJF, Mr. Maxwell Jacob Friedman, Mr. Salt of the Earth, will be around for a very long time. Oh, the dog!